So I'm a big believer in transparency, so bear with me. Shaper is not an easy place to work at. It's a hard place to work at, but it's super rewarding.
The people who surround you all want to make this product really, really good. And those tough feedbacks and those ideas that other people share are all there to improve your work as a designer.
There are very few places where there are almost no limit at all to the level of involvement, to the level of focus you can go into quality, into product quality. There is certainly a big appreciation towards getting into the domain, understanding the intricacies and the details of a certain solution, and this is one of our top priorities.
I think one of the things that gets tricky here is finding the balance between trying to make something really, really great and then also trying to make that an iterative process. So lots of times it's about like finding the part where you can just cut the scope a bit and release a first version, a first meaningful version.
But also it's pretty standard that when a product change causes some weird data patterns, then we talk to developers and we try to figure out together what code change might have caused that.
And it's really rewarding when you figure out something and get closer to the answer that, oh, that's the reason why it looks so funny. And it involves a lot of talking to people even outside of the team.
Our work is like more like a constant dialogue between design and the implementation. So we often do a lot of prototype implementations where we can discuss how we should progress with the design and what should be changed, how can we polish these things to make a perfectly good balance between the technical details and the user value.
If we have a problem or we need to talk about an idea, it's the easiest way to jump in the meeting room and start the ideation, and usually with Alex we rarely come out of the meeting room without a proper solution.
So we are working on a productivity tool. It requires a certain amount of predictability, consistency, familiarity, but it also requires a certain amount of a sparkle here and there. Some surprises what you get along the way using Shaper. To be able to come up with both of these, which are kind of contradicting to each other, our unique way is to basically make sure that everyone is constantly embedded in this stream of information, this stream of context. I think there is a huge reliance on individual ownership, and there is certainly a granted autonomy to be able to execute on that ownership. This ownership is practically has no limits, which is very intimidating at first, for sure. It's definitely not for everyone.
This is what keeps me going, because there's always gonna be like a new challenge that you need to figure out, and this is what makes you feel alive.
I think this is one of the most committed team and hardworking team I've ever worked with. And that's also the hard part of it, that you have to show up dedicated and committed every day and show your best.
And in this way, we could partake in decisions which influenced the roadmap of a whole team and how the users are accessing their design in the future, which is pretty amazing as a data person.
The one most important thing is that even though that you're surrounded with seasoned professionals in every single position, the general attributes towards you as a newcomer is that they treating you like on the same level. So you can feel this humbleness that regardless of your seniority level, you're always listened to. And it's very encouraging as a newcomer.
We have such a great talent pool along the company with bright people, with extreme hobbies that we can chat about in everyday life. Such as, for example, we have an engineer who is roasting coffee at home. We have a cycling squad that goes cycling every week. Or we even have a chess section where we share our moves.
For me, one of the most important things is the people who we can collaborate with. Working with these super smart and super capable people who you can always learn something new, and it does not have to be anything about CAD. Sometimes it's about CAD, sometimes it's about math, sometimes it's about programming, but sometimes it's about making cheese or making beer, and that's like, it's just so wonderful. And the other thing is the actual problem that we are solving, like making an impact in the world's manufacturing capabilities. That's also something that keeps me going.
One piece of advice I would give to people joining Shaper is to be patient, because 3D modeling space is very complex and it's quite intimidating at first until you get to know everything, until you build up that knowledge so that you can understand the terminology. So just be patient and you will be learning very much.
I was promised a few things. One of them was brutal honesty, very direct feedback. I have been to startups, quite a few of them actually, and this wasn't a unique promise. What was definitely surprising is that Shaper certainly delivered on that promise.
So I would say that you should only join if you really, really want it and if you want to grow, because that's something that we are looking for. Somebody who really wants to grow, somebody who's willing to do the extra mile, so you can work with very smart and very capable people. And just having like day-to-day collaboration with people like that is exciting enough. And like trying to achieve the ambitions, goals that we have, that's also a super exciting and a proud thing to be part of the team.